Hello children, I welcome you all to the science class. This is the second period for today. We have completed chapter 2 and we have done few exercises, that is exercise A, B and C in your book. So in today's class we will continue with the exercises, that is number D. We will answer the given questions, children. Okay, there are total 8 questions, children. I have skipped some questions because that will be enough for you. So I have done only 6 questions from your book. So number D, answer the following question. Number 1, how is soil important to living things? So we have learned in our class that soil is very much important for us. Yes, living things means us, animals, plants, humans, we all are living things. So the first question is, how is soil important to living things? Soil is important to living things for following reasons. That is number 1, rocks and soil are used in all types of construction. So you know that rocks, soil, yes, these all are used for building different types of buildings. Yes, different types of buildings, forts, monuments, all these are built with the help of rocks and soil. We use gravel, sand, cement. So all these are built with the help of rocks and soil. So number 1 importance is, rocks and soil are used in all types of constructions. Number 2, coal and petrol are also found in the soil. In the class, in the book, in the explanation, we have learned that coal and petrol, which we use for driving different vehicles, these are found under the soil. So coal and petrol are also found in the soil. Number 3, soil is the home to many animals and insects. We know that soil, many animals and insects live under the soil or on the soil. So it is the home for many animals and insects. Children, you have to learn all 3 importance, that is important of soil for living things. And another important is also there, that all the plants grow on the soil. Yes, and we are totally dependent on plants directly or indirectly. So that is also one important. If you want to write that important of soil, you can write that one also. Okay, so let us see number 2 and number 3. Number 2 question, how is soil formed? So this we have learned in the beginning of the chapter only, that soil is formed by the breaking of the rocks by the effect of wind, heat and flowing water. So we have learned that soil is formed when the rocks are broken down into smaller pieces, and it doesn't occur like within 5 days, 6 days. It takes thousands of years to form soil. Yes, so soil is formed by the breaking of rocks by the effect of, with the help of wind, heat and flowing water. That means heat, wind and flowing water causes the breakdown of rocks. So when these large rocks are broken down into smaller pieces, and those smaller pieces of gravel are further broken down into minute particles, then the soil is formed. Hope number 2 answer is clear. Number 3, name the different kinds of soil. So here in the book, in your question, it was written name and describe the different kinds of soil. Children, it will be more for you if you go for the description of the soil. So you will just write the name of the soil you have learned in this chapter. Okay, so the 3 different kinds of soil are sandy soil, clay soil and loam soil, or you can call it loamy soil also. What are the 3 kinds of soil? Sandy soil, clay soil and loam soil. Okay, you don't have to describe about all this soil, you just have to write the name of the soil. Next, children, number 4, what is humus? So humus is a layer of dead parts of plants and animals in the soil. So humus, children, we know that where the humus is present, that soil is very fertile for the growth of the plant. For example, loamy soil, it is very rich in humus. So what is this humus? Humus is a layer of dead parts of plants and animals in the soil. Where the dead parts of plants and animals are there in the soil, that part is known as humus. Okay. So next, number 5 and number 6 children. Number 5, which soil is best for the growth of plants? Very easy question, we have learned it. Which soil is best for the growth of plants? Yes, loam is best for the growth of plants. So loamy soil is children, loamy soil, it is a mixture of, we know, sand and clay soil. So it can hold water also and it can hold air also in proper amount. That is why loam is best for the growth of plant. And also we have learned that loam contains enough humus. Yes, we know that loamy soil is rich in humus. That is why loam is best for the growth of plants. Now next children, name some animals which make their homes in the soil. So you can directly write the names of animal without writing any statement. Rabbits, rats, moles, earthworms, snakes, etc. If you want to add more name of more animals, you can add, it is your choice. So what are the animals that which make their homes in the soil? Rabbits, rats, moles, earthworms and snakes. Next children, you will draw the given picture in your science copy, okay? So this is a composition of the soil. We have done activity for this. Yes, it's in activity 2, that when we pick a handful of soil and put it on the beaker, in the beaker, and add water to it and let it settle for few times, we see that the soil is divided into different particles with different layers. Yes, in the bottom gravel will settle, then after sand particles, then after clay, then after the humus will float above the water. Okay, so this is the composition of the soil children. You need to draw this and you need to label it also. Label means you will write everything, that it's a gravel, it's a clay particle, it's a sand particle, it's a humus. You will write everything after drawing. You can simply draw a beaker and you can simply do the diagram and label it. It is important for your exams. Okay, so we are over with this chapter children. Yes, hope you have understood whatever we did in this class from this chapter. I want to say you one thing, that number 6 children, number 6, question number 6 where I have written, it is question number 8 in your book. Okay, I forgot to tell that thing. It is question number 8 in your book. That is why I have written 8 in the bracket. So, thank you children. I will see you in the next class. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you everyone.